Today, I'm announcing the new lineup.
来了, PM Lee has just announced a new all-star lineup for his cabinet. Hey, no, not that cabinet, for parliament lah.
So in the next 60 seconds, we're going to quickly go through all the major changes announced today. Ready? Let's go. Chan Chun Seng, who was previously the Minister for Trade and Industry, will now be the Minister for Education. Lawrence Wong, who was second Minister for Finance, will now be promoted to take over DPM Heng as Finance Minister. Ong Ye Kung, who was appointed as Minister for Transport in July 2020, will now take over as the Health Minister. Which also means that he will be the co-chair for the COVID-19 Multi-Ministry Task Force with Lawrence Wong. And Desmond Lee? Well, Desmond Lee is still the National Development Minister. Gan Kim Yong, who has been leading the fight against the pandemic as Health Minister, will now take over the Ministry of Trade and Industry. Tan Si Leng, who will continue as second Minister at MTI, has now been promoted to take over the Ministry of Manpower from Josephine Teo, who will now be the Communications Minister. She will continue to be the second Minister of Home Affairs. S. Iswaran, who has been the Communications Minister for the past 2 years, will now take over as Transport Minister. He will continue to be the Minister in charge of Trade Relations at MTI. Oh no, I'm running out of time. Okay. Sim Ann will take over as Senior Minister for Foreign Affairs. Koh Poh Koon will take over as Senior Minister of Manpower. Tan Kiat Hau will take over as MOS of Communications. Josephine Teo will take over the Smart Nation Initiative from Vivian Balakrishnan and the Cyber Security Agency of Singapore from S. Iswaran. Edwin Tong will take over as Deputy Chairman of the People's Association from Chan Chun Seng. And Chee Hong Tat will join NTUC replacing Koh Poh Koon. Phew. Okay, I guess that's everything. But you might be wondering, so what? Well, this reshuffle was triggered because DPM Heng decided to step down as finance minister and step aside as leader of the 4G ministers. PM Lee said that the redeployment of ministers will allow some of the other ministers to get fresh responsibilities and gain different exposure and experiences. So these could be the next steps for 4G leadership and the future Prime Minister of Singapore.